So this is one of the coolest thing about this track nation. So they use an audio visualizer thing over here. So most of the viewers are just attracted towards this audio visualizer. So in this video, we're going to be creating a music visualizer with 3.JS. Before getting started, let's understand what is meant by WebAudio API. The WebAudio API involves in handling the audio operations inside an audio context and has been designed to allow modular routing. Basic audio operations are performed with audio nodes, which are linked together to form an audio routing graph. Several sources with different types of channel layouts are supported even with a single context. This modular design provides the flexibility to create complex audio functions with dynamic effects. Alright, so let's get started by building the basic block. So first I started with only the sphere in the scene and transformed it. As this turned out to be a simpler task, I added two planar meshes later on to give the scene more depth. The good part about the 3.JS is that after you are done with the basic setup, it's fairly easy to focus on adding or removing things. For this scene, we need few basic things. A scene which contains everything, a light or two, a camera, a render that renders everything, all the objects, groups, and the render loop. The core idea of this visualizer was about modulating a sphere's size based on the beat signature and deform its surface based on the vocal. To make it interesting, I used some procedural noise that adds some physical textures to the ball using the audio data as an input. So let's get started with the body. So first let's link all those JavaScript files and let's add a div ID called content, and let's add the input source label over here, and let's add an audio controls over here, and finally let's add div ID called out. Alright, so let's build the CSS file. So first let's add some important colors and some background color textures, and also let's add some of its position and let's transform it to 3D structure. Heading over to the JavaScript files, first let's create a noise variable and let's create a vis init function and let's add its audio file and the file label as well. So first we're gonna create an onload function, so if the file is chosen, we're gonna be playing the audio. So then let's add some file on change, so if the audio is playing, we're gonna be visualizing those audio effects over here. And let's create a function called play, and let's adjust its frequency layer by just vibrating those particles over here, and let's create a plane geometry and the renderer size. So then let's create a plane 2 and setting its mesh and its plane material, and finally let's add some ball in order to make the ball vibrating once the audio is played, and let's add some ambient light and also the spotlight. So finally let's group all those things over here, and finally let's resize this window. So then let's add a function called render. So in this render we're going to be creating an half array and an upper array, so in which we're going to be vibrating its upper portion and its lower portion, so in which we're going to be vibrating its upper plane and its lower plane as well. So let's call make rough ball and make rough ground function. So let's vibrate its mean portion by just adjusting its frequency, so the make rough ball shouldn't interfere with the top and down layer, so in which we're going to be vibrating between those up and down layer. So that I'm just adding some of the functions like modular upper average frequency, so it should be just 0, 1, and 0 and 4, in which it will be vibrating between those upper plane and the lower plane, and which should not interfere with the another. So that's it. So then let's add an render with scene and camera, and let's request the animation frame from the render. So finally let's set its fractionate, modulate, average and max values. Smash the like button and consider subscribing, and I'll catch up in the next one.